Two journalists with the Reuters news agency were back in court in Myanmar on Wednesday. They're accused of possessing state secrets, but insist they were simply doing their jobs covering the Rohingya crisis. And they'd met two police officers for dinner and were arrested when those officers handed them a bundle of documents. Not long after that, authorities dug up a mass grave in a Rohingya village. One of the journalists, still in handcuffs, said police learned about the massacre because of reporting by both him and his colleagues.
We were arrested while covering the news. We covered the Indian story, as you know. Aung San Suu Kyi said it is new that the top Madah had admitted to what had happened. Nobody recognized that we were the first ones that shed light on that fact.
Mark Pierce is Country Director for Save the Children. He joins us now live from Cox's Bazar in Bangladesh. Mark, thank you for taking the time. Just on the story with the journalists, the military has now admitted to carrying out that massacre in Indian Village. It's an area where officials continue to block media access. And that lack of information from that part of Myanmar continues to be a major concern.
Well, of course it is, and we've called for some independent monitoring of the situation. But there is a dire lack of information coming out of that area.
Let's move on. Save Children has released this comprehensive report of what life is like for the children in those refugee camps. According to interviews, their fears include wild elephants and snakes, violent men lurking in the forest, and human traffickers on the prowl during the night. In general, children are very resilient, but how do they cope with this type of trauma?
That's a very good point. You know, the children have experienced a lot of trauma in this crisis, and they continue to experience a lot of trauma. They have fear of violence and sexual assault. They have fears of kidnapping and trafficking. And of course, they're also worried about their own health and whether or not they'll have enough food to eat. So it's really important that we try to do everything we can to try to appease them and try to address those fears and provide whatever assistance we can.
Well, those fears will be growing with monsoon season on its way because the rains are expected to cause some major damage to the camps. What is being done to shore up, you know, those very flimsy structures and to try and prepare the area for the rain and essentially save lives?
Yeah, absolutely. There's 100,000 people at great risk in terms of landslides, flooding, and of course, that would follow this would be perhaps a health crisis. And so Save the Children is addressing it by trying to improve people's shelters, trying to build basic and improve basic infrastructure such as drainage and bridges. Also in terms of improving the early warning system so that people can plan and get out of the way of the floods or they can and find a higher ground or better ground to protect themselves.
Do they have an escape plan? Have you been sort of showing them where they need to go when the rains come? Do they have like a route worked out?
Well, very good question. You have basically 700,000 or 800,000 people living in a very limited geographic area. So where to go is part of the problem. So we're trying to reinforce embankments on hills in order to better protect the hills from landslides, and also trying to see what provisions can be made to evacuate people to cyclone shelters or other safe places.
It's 100,000 people. God, I mean, it's incredible to think just how difficult that will be when the rains come. Finally here, three female Nobel laureates, they visited the camps there in Bangladesh over the last couple of days. They wanted to arrange this meeting with Aung San Suu Kyi. There was no response. Mary Maguire had this message for Aung San Suu Kyi, the de facto leader of Myanmar, and also a Nobel Peace Prize winner. Listen to this.
The Rohingya people have every right to have their citizenship, their safety, their security. They have a right to human rights and democracy, as have the other 135 ethnic groups within Burma. So we look forward to visiting our sister laureate, and we hope that she will have and be supported by the people of the world the courage to speak out against the genocide that has been carried out by the Burmese military.
It was a little difficult to hear, Mark, so let me paraphrase. She basically said all children have a right to live, and she was asking for all leaders, including Suu Kyi, to have the courage to speak out against the genocide. At this point, is there any hope or any realistic expectation that Suu Kyi will actually do anything to end these atrocities?
Well, it's very difficult for me to comment on that. I don't know the situation in Myanmar very well. I will say that it is very important that the international community step up and try to find a durable solution to this terrible refugee crisis. It is the children that are most affected. This is a children's emergency. 55% of all the new arrivals are children. That's almost 400,000. So it is, I would say that it's very important that all leaders really step up and try to address the underlying problems of this crisis.
Very quickly, so we have a little bit of time left, but world leaders are not stepping up to help out with this problem. So what can anybody out there do who wants to help? What are their options to help out the Rohingya right now?
Well, I would suggest that people contribute to organizations like Save the Children. For $35, we can feed a family of seven for a month. For $50, we can provide therapeutic food for a child that's malnourished. And for $1,000, we can make sure that children are able to learn and they're better protected through child-friendly spaces. So it is great if people can step up and contribute because this is a tragedy that no child should face.
And this is a group of people who are not being helped in any serious way by anyone around the world, I guess from apart from Bangladesh, which is hosting them in these refugee camps, so that's about it. But Mark, we are now out of time, but thank you so much. It is always good to see you.
Thank you.